The Minister for Works and Transport, General Edward Katumba Wamala, has announced the total closure of Karuma Bridge to all traffic starting on Monday, September 23, 2024. Katumba said that the contractor, National Enterprise Corporation, NEC, and China 7th Railway Group will immediately start the demolition of the concrete deck to allow major works for its restoration, an exercise expected to last 3 months. The Uganda National Roads Authority, UNRA, has also announced alternative routes for motorists. Motorists from Kampala heading to Gulu and West Nile are expected to use Luero, Kafo, Masindi and Para to connect to Pakwach or Gulu via Oluyom, and vice versa for motorists from Gulu and West Nile. Today, legislators hailing from Northern Uganda and West Nile have expressed concern over the closure of the bridge, saying it's a total hindrance to the development of Northern Uganda since it's a strategic route connecting Midwestern, Northern Uganda and West Nile sub-region.
I'm telling you, the closure of Karuma have subjected our people into total suffering. Many of the bus owners have parked their buses, aware that they are on loan. Now they cannot traverse the long distance. The cost of fuel has doubled.
In case they go ahead with their plan of trying to close Karuma and allowing vehicles to move via Para, via the park, then there should be no charges. Because small vehicles have been charged a lot of money. This will be around 80,000, 90,000 or 100,000 shillings. That's a lot of money.
Karuma Bridge was temporarily closed to heavy vehicles in April this year after an assessment established defects in its structures. The executive director for UNEB, Dan Odon, has banned the transportation of examination material using boda-boda motorcycles, which he said has been found to compromise the security and standards of the examination exercise. Speaking during the launch of a two-day seminar which attracted stakeholders in the education sector, including district education officers, as well as examination officers at Chambogo, Odon said transporting examinations in some districts has proven to be unsafe, noting that criminals have infiltrated the exercise.
We have evidence that in some districts in the past, the recent past, we have even had people who are distributing exams and the only qualification they had was that they owned border borders. So they were being engaged to distribute exams. And because they are not aware of the sensitivity of the work that they were doing, criminals infiltrated the system.
Odon has, however, expressed frustrations with the pace at which the courts handle the cases of examination malpractices. He revealed that since the year 2021, the examination malpractice cases have not been heard to date, whereas other suspects have been acquitted of the charges, even with the convincing evidence provided.
We had even an acquittal, and we could not understand how a person who is caught red-handed with all the evidence could be acquitted for lack of evidence.
U.S. Secretary Anthony Blinken has denied reports that the United States had prior knowledge of the deadly attack in Lebanon that saw hundreds of Hezbollah members' pages explode.
The United States did not know about, nor was it involved in, these incidents, and we're still gathering the information and gathering the facts. Broadly speaking, we've been very clear, and we remain very clear, about the importance of all parties avoiding any steps that could further escalate the conflict that we're trying to resolve in Gaza, to see it spread to other fronts.
Hezbollah has vowed to retaliate against Israel after hundreds of paging devices used by the militant group exploded in a deadly wave across Lebanon, raising fears of an all-out war. In a statement, Hezbollah said Israel was fully responsible for this criminal aggression. It reiterated it would avenge the attack while vowing to continue its fight against Israel in support of Hamas in the Gaza war. Cross-border exchanges with Israeli forces were ongoing and separate from the difficult reckoning that the criminal enemy must wait for its massacre. Hezbollah leader Hassan Nasrallah is due to give a televised address tomorrow. There was no comment from Israel on the explosions that killed 12 people, including 2 children, and wounded up to 2,800 others.